Hello, I'm Erica Sargent with CBS Chicago. Here are stories making news at this hour. A judge has granted bail to Jackie Wilson a week after overturning his conviction in the 1982 slaying of two Chicago police officers. CBS 2's V. Nguyen reports.
Hi everyone, I'm V. Nguyen with CBS 2 News. I'm at the criminal courthouse where a judge granted bail for Jackie Wilson. He was convicted of shooting and killing two Chicago police officers in 1982 and was serving a life sentence. A judge overturned his conviction and ordered a new trial in the case, saying that Wilson was tortured into a confession by police commander and detective John Burge. Now today, a judge granted Jackie Wilson bail and ordered him released on a personal recognizance bond. Mr. Wilson still needs to be processed and could walk out later this afternoon. His next court date is scheduled for August.
A total of 66 children separated from their parents as a result of the Trump administration's zero tolerance policy on illegal border crossings have been brought to Chicago. Roseanne Tejas has that story.
Senator Dick Durbin is in the monitor behind me. He is holding up a card that he says his granddaughter made to share with the children he visited at a residential facility run by Heartland Alliance today. These are children who are living in the Chicago area due to the president's zero tolerance policy. We're told these are children, many of them who have come within the last few weeks. And Senator Durbin said these simple little cards really did a lot to cheer them up. He told us a lot about these children today that we didn't know. One third of the 66 children who are placed here in Chicago are under the age of 5. He described seeing toddlers and babies at this facility that he likened to a daycare center. Now, he also told us that Heartland themselves told us that they have been able to locate relatives of many of the children they are holding, but not with any help from the government. Rather, they use clues provided by the children themselves and also did a lot of sleuthing to try and find relatives. None of the relatives were here in the Chicago area, but they at least have made contacts with some family members. But the question is, how will families be reunited? And Senator Durbin said the president's order the other day reversing this policy does little to explain what happens now. And Senator Durbin says on Monday he will meet with a bipartisan group of senators to determine how best to reunify some of the families that have been separated at the border due to the zero tolerance policy.
And here is meteorologist Mary Kay Kleist with your forecast.
Hi, everybody. While most of the heavy rain is moving away from Chicago, we still have some flooding issues in northwest Indiana into Newton and Jasper counties, where we do have a flash flood warning until 7 o'clock this evening. Intense amounts of rain, already 2 to 3 inches, has fallen. But now we have slow-moving thunderstorms near Rensselaer, near Carpenter and Milroy and Kentland and Iroquois. So we're watching that as showers and storms lift from Lafayette into Newton and Jasper County. They're nearly stationary, just really bringing those incredible amounts of rain into the picture. Lightning too, so we could see flash flooding in parts of Newton and Jasper County this afternoon and evening. It is so cool temperature wise. We're at 59 at Chicago's lakefront. It's 60 in Waukegan, 62 in DeKalb, a little warmer there in Valparaiso, 72, and it's 70 in Kankakee. So as we move through the night, there's only a stray shower chance for the city of Chicago. Well, south of I-80 would be a better chance where you could still see some leftover showers, otherwise lakefront fog. Now, on your weekend, it looks like Saturday will be mostly cloudy with highs around 77 degrees. A tiny chance of a stray shower, mainly in the afternoon, but not all of us will get one. And then finally clearing on Sunday with a high of 81 degrees.